Welcome to Biology Online Class from the Gopi Krishna High School. Yes. Last class we have discussed about the vitamins and deficiency disease. About this water soluble vitamins. Yes. Water soluble vitamins. What are the water soluble vitamins? Vitamin B and the vitamin C are the water soluble vitamins. Vitamin B and the vitamin C are the water soluble vitamins. Vitamin B and the vitamin C are water soluble vitamins.
Yes.
So, in which B vitamin? Already I told you last class only. Vitamin B is the B complex vitamin. It has several vitamins. That's why it is a group of vitamins, B complex vitamin.
Yes.
It has several vitamins. They are thiamine. Riboflavin. Niacin, pantothenic acid, biotin, pyridoxine. Folic acid.
Yes.
Scopolamine.
Yes.
Already we discussed about that. Thiamine, riboflavin, niacin, pantothenic acid, biotin, pyridoxine and folic acid. The remaining vitamin is scopolamine.
Yes.
Cyanocobalamin. It is also one of the B complex vitamin. Chemical name is B12. The chemical name of cyanocobalamin is the B12 vitamin. This is cyanocobalamin. What is the requirement? Cyanocobalamin is required for the metabolism of nucleic acids. Metabolism of nucleic acids. Cyanocobalamin chemical name is B12. It is required for the metabolism of nucleic acids. You know what are the nucleic acids? DNA and RNA, these are the nucleic acids. Cyanocobalamin is required for the metabolism of nucleic acid, DNA and RNA. Yes, what are the sources? Vitamin B12 or cyanocobalamin, it is not readily available in the food. Means it is not available in the plant sources of food or animal sources of food. But how our body will get this vitamin B12? Already I told you at the beginning of this lesson, we will get the vitamins in two ways. One is through our diet, another one is synthesized by bacteria present in our body. So this B12 cyanocobalamin vitamin, it is also synthesized by bacteria present in our small intestine. What are the bacteria present in our small intestine? They are synthesized the cyanocobalamin vitamin and is stored in the liver.
Yes.
Stored in liver. Yes. Cyanocobalamin is stored in the liver. In the human body, where the B12 vitamin is stored? liver.
Yes.
Deficiency of this anagogalbin causes the pernicious anemia. Very severe anemia. To the human body, the minimum percent of hemoglobin required to the human body is 9 to 12%, means 9 to 12 grams per deciliter of the blood. Simply it is say as a points, 9 points, 10 points, 12 points, like. So average between 9 to 12. If it will be less than this 10 or less than this 8, that is called as anemia. Either 8 or 7, that is the anemia. If the hemoglobin will be either 2 or 3 grams per the deciliter of the blood, that means 2 points or 3 points, that is the pernicious anemia. It is very dangerous. People who are suffering this pernicious anemia, sometimes they will die. Why? It is not readily available to the food. When person have the good health, then bacteria present in our intestine producing this cyanocobalamin. So, what are the symptoms of pernicious anemia? Hemoglobin will be very less and person becomes very lean. Then, at the final stage, water is accumulated as deposited in the interstellar spaces. Swelling is occurs in the face and the limbs and finally will die. That's why to cure this pernicious anemia blood is must be administered to the person. Blood is must be administered to the person who are suffering from the pernicious anemia. So that is about the B complex vitamin. Yes. Next B vitamin, yes. All these 8 are the B complex vitamins. Now we will discuss another water soluble vitamin, is a vitamin C. Yes. Vitamin C. The chemical name of vitamin C is the ascorbic acid. The chemical name of vitamin C is the ascorbic acid. You know what is the requirement? Vitamin C is required for the oxidation. Oxidation process in the cellular respiration. Vitamin C is required for the oxidation and reduction reactions. That occurs in the cellular respiration. Vitamin C is also required for healing of wounds and bone fractures. Wounds and bone fractures. Healing of the wounds and the bone fractures. Vitamin C is also required for the formation of collagen.
Yes.
Formation of collagen.
Yes.
So, what is the requirement of vitamin C? Vitamin C is required for the oxidation and reduction reactions in the cellular respiration, healing of the wounds and bone fractures, and formation of collagen. You know what is the collagen? It is one of the protein substances present in the connective tissues like ligament and tendon. These two are the connective tissues. Ligament is connecting the one bone with another bone. So bones are attached to each other. Our bones are attached together by means of ligament connective tissue. Bone is connecting with the muscles by the tendon. Two bones are joined by ligament. One bone we which is connecting with the muscle is a tendon. Yes, these two are made up of a protein is called collagen.
Yes,
this collagen is act as a grease, lubricate. So in this way, vitamin C is also required for the formation of collagen.
Yes.
What are the sources of vitamin C?
Yes,
sources. Vitamin sources, vitamin C sources, citrus fruits. Citrus fruits. Fresh leafy vegetables.
Citrus fruits are
fresh leafy vegetables are and guava fruit.
Yes, guava fruit
is the cheapest sources, means available at low cost.
Guava fruit
and the Indian gooseberry, amla. Amla is the richest source of vitamin C. Amla is the richest source of vitamin C. Amla in Telugu usuri. Emblema of its knowledge. Yes. All these are the. And even sprouts also, germinating seeds also. Sources of vitamin C are citrus fruits, fresh leafy vegetables. Cheapest source is the guava fruit. Richest source of vitamin C is the amla, and it is also available in the sprouts. In the sprouts also vitamin C is available.
Yes.
Next, deficiency disease. What are the diseases are caused by deficiency of vitamin C?
Yes.
Deficiency of vitamin C causes the scurvy disease. What is the disease is caused by deficiency of vitamin C? Deficiency of vitamin C causes a scurvy disease. What are the symptoms of scurvy disease? Yes, swollen gums. Gums are swelling and the bleeding is occurs through the gums. Bleeding is occurs through the gums. Symptoms of scurvy disease are gums are swollen and the bleeding is occurs through the gums. And also skin is cracks at the elbows. Skin is cracks at the elbows. They are the symptoms of scurvy disease.
Yes.
All these are the water soluble vitamins. Let us discuss about that fat soluble vitamins. Fat soluble vitamins. What are the fat soluble vitamins? Fat soluble vitamins are vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E and vitamin K. A, D, E, K. They are the fat soluble vitamins. Yes. First we will discuss about the vitamin A. The chemical name of vitamin A is a retinol.
Yes,
chemical name is a retinol. Chemical name. Yes, chemical name of vitamin A is a retinol. This vitamin A is required. What is the requirement of vitamin A?
Yes.
Vitamin A is required for the normal vision. Normal vision. And the formation of rhodopsin and iodopsin. Yes, rhodopsin and iodopsin present in the rod and cone cells. Rods and cones. You know what are the rods and cones? In the internal section of the eye, three layers are there. They are arranged one below the another. The outermost layer is the sclerotic layer. Middle layer is called choroid layer. Inner layer is called retina. So, this inner layer retina, that is made up of two types of photoreceptor cells. They are rod cells and cone cells. Rod cells contain a pigment is called rhodopsin. Cone cells are containing a pigment is called iodopsin. For the formation of this rhodopsin and iodopsin also, vitamin A is required. Okay? What are the sources of vitamin A? Sources, what are the sources? Both plant and animal sources are available. Plant sources. Leafy vegetables. What are the leafy vegetables? Cabbage, spinach, amaranthus, drumstick leaves. These are the leafy vegetables. What are the vegetables? Carrot, drumsticks.
Money.